here at AUVSI, and we're very excited because we're showcasing some state-of-the-art new technologies. It was just this week that we released the latest version of the Pathfinder report. Precision Hawk has been working hand-in-hand with the FAA and a number of other companies to really start to evaluate best practices and safety cases to allow both companies and organizations and individuals to fly beyond visual line of sight. And we released the report this week, and we've made it available to the public at FAAPathfinderReport.com. And you can read how you put together a safety case, the type of training required, and the technology to allow companies to fly a drone up to 50 miles. And what we're showcasing here at the conference is our implementation, taking those recommendations from the Pathfinder report and then implementing them. So we're here today to talk about a new multi-rotor drone that can not only fly 40 miles, but has some of the technology that was referenced in the Pathfinder report, such as the acoustic-based aircraft detection system. So while our drone is flying, in addition to cooperative aircraft that have ADS-B transponders that our drone will pick up, if there's a non-cooperative aircraft, let's say a small crop duster or helicopter that's not picked up on radar or doesn't have an ADS-B transponder, our drone can hear that for up to a 10-kilometer radius around the drone, instantly alert the pilot, who can then move the drone out of the way, or if the pilot doesn't respond, the drone will automatically lower itself to the ground. And this is the type of technology that's needed and required to help move this industry to being able to fly beyond visual line of sight. We've partnered with a company, Xfold, that makes drones here in the United States, as well as partnered with a number of other component providers to put together a multi-rotor drone that has all of the needs to meet the requirements and the recommendations for flying BV law. So we use a hybrid engine that's both electric and gas that keeps the drone in the air for about 2 hours and lets us do about 40 miles. We have a GPS tracker, long-range communications, and even a parachute. But the real key features of our multi-rotor drone is that it's using a product of ours called Lattice, which is a data feed that includes the Harris real-time data feed of all ADS-B compliant aircraft. And it has the SARA acoustic-based aircraft detection system. So between those two things, it's aware of all the aircraft in the vicinity. And if one comes nearby, it can alert the pilot and lower itself out of the way. So we think this is the first of a new breed of drone technology that can truly fly autonomously and beyond the current 1 mile limit for flying within visual line of sight. At Precision Hawk, we're really a full solution set provider. So we work with some clients that come to us and say, hey, take a large utility company. They have 10,000 miles of electrical line. They're paying between $200 and $400 per mile every year to have a helicopter fly it, with someone leaning out dangerously, taking pictures or driving down notes of where the sag of the line is too low or this vegetation encroachment. They're looking at buying some of these drones to be able to fly over, do long range analysis, and get higher quality image at a much lower price. But we also work with some clients that don't want to buy a drone at all. They just want the data the drones can provide, and they come to us and we provide it as drones as a service. So we actually will go out there and we'll use our technology to collect the data and give them the end result, and everything in between. So we really consider ourselves a full solution set provider that can either help you set up your own drone divisions or fly the missions for you and just give you the data that you need at the end of the day. There's pretty extensive pre-planning to be able to go ahead and fly BV law. So first of all, we have a whole safety case that we've built out, and the Pathfinder report talks about this in more detail. It identifies the checklist that you need to go through, what the operating environment needs to look like. It talks about the training recommendations that your pilot should have a certain amount of hours on the drone, have flown a certain amount of extended line of sight missions, being trained by someone who can already fly BV loss. And lastly, it says use a drone with certain technology to identify both cooperative aircraft, aircraft that have an ADS-B transponder, as well as non-cooperative aircraft. And you gotta kinda check the box on all of those prior to your mission and make sure that you have the right safety case, you have pilots that have the right training, and you're using the right technology to be able to fly the mission. I think this is the year where you're gonna see some of the greatest advancements in BV loss. The challenge hasn't just been regulation, it's been that small commercial drones aren't able to fly these long distances. So it doesn't matter that you can't fly your drone for more than a mile when the majority of the drones out there don't go more than 1 or 2 miles away. Because there's a lot of challenges you have to solve. You need an engine, an electrical package that can power the drone for a 2, 3, or 4 hour flight. You need a comms package that can, when the drone's that far away, still communicate back. You need autonomous flight so it can avoid obstacles and be aware of aircraft. And what's so interesting and what we're seeing this year is not only is the FAA starting to grant more BV loss waivers, and not only with the Pathfinder project is there now a blueprint that companies can follow to truly fly BV loss, but the technology is making that next step forward too. So I'm not sure true BV loss flight for these more smaller commercial drones was even possible before this year, but it's all coming together. So I think that this year is going to be the year where you're going to see big strides made and the industry start to adopt BV loss in a much larger way.
Based on the popular Sling 2 LSA, the Sling 4 was designed to be the most practical and desirable lightweight four-place experimental aircraft on the market. Find out more about this 115-horsepower turbocharged airplane at airplanefactory.com. Concorde's recombinant gas RG series sealed battery technology produces a high-performance battery with the advantages of being pre-tested and fully charged at the factory. Find out more about Concorde's entire line of batteries at www.concordebattery.com. Concorde, the heart of your aircraft.